Hello and welcome back to Massive Chalice. Where we left off last time was getting right into our first battle where we're defending some part of this island area. So the plan is to go around into the foggy area and kill off all of the monsters. So I'm gonna take small steps forward until we know what we're dealing with. Like little steps at a time, and then just so we can, if we find something, we can shoot it immediately. Oh, there's something. I guess that person is pretty far sight. Can they shoot in that area? No. And the other people, I don't think have the, oops, have the ability to see that little thing. Yes, they can't shoot it. Perhaps if they shoot through the egg, they might be able to see it and kill it. But I'm not sure if that's a possibility. I'm gonna try that. So I'm gonna have the person in back shoot through this egg thing over here. And then that might. Yep, this person can now shoot this guy. And this person didn't kill that guy, because it has to be annoying. We could. I don't think it's worth using up a potion. As you see, we only have five of these potions to use. And I don't think it's worth it to use it on maybe hitting this, maybe missing. You see, there's only like a 50% chance of hitting it. So I'm just gonna have everyone stay here until the seedling or whatever that's called comes to us. Or the seed. There it is. So it's gonna do a little bit of damage. Actually, that's a lot considering they don't have a whole lot of health. Well, let's just attack this guy with melee. That's interesting. Its health went up, but I didn't notice. Let's have the other alchemist come over here. There we go. I just didn't want to use up anything important. So let's have the archers, the ranged people. What are they called? Hunters. The hunters come up forward. I don't think there's anything over here to be worried about. So when I was getting an image for the thumbnail, I went into a past game so I could like get a better look at the island kind of thing, and I noticed that I was playing on normal, which I'm pretty sure is the easiest level, so there's a good chance that this isn't gonna work out 100% excellently. So, just wanted that little disclaimer there. I think, let's hope we can kill this guy. Awesome. And did you just level up, or? Yes, awesome. Let's bring you over here. I want you to shoot this seed, but I don't think that's possible. Let's destroy this egg. Oh no, you can kill the seed by just going over there. Yeah, let's do that. Cool. And I don't think we can reach that one yet, so I'll just have you come over here. Just use up all of your moves, and let's just move everybody a little bit forward. All the way up. So in my experience, the best way to not die in this game is to have everyone level up as much as possible. So that means having I think if I can get an archer, not an archer, an alchemist over there, they could kill them all in one go, which I really want to do. I'm gonna move this guy over. So there's a building, I think it was called the Crucible, that if you put high enough levels in there, it levels people up, and I've noticed that just having higher levels is one of the easiest ways to survive these dungeons really well, because it makes them very strong. So we can't reach there. I might just have to end up shooting one of them with an arrow. This is what I think I'm just gonna do. Well, I guess that's just gonna have to happen. I could shoot this guy, or that guy. Let's get the one closest to us. So now we only have two left to kill, and we should be able to do it pretty easily once they come over this way or we move these guys up that way. Let's just get them all clustered around here. This is actually a bad strategy. Ooh. Oh, is that a lapse? For if the enemy can use area of effect damage stuff. Ooh, that person's not doing well. I'm just. Oh, we don't have the health potions yet. So I'm gonna have her move back. She might die in this. There's a fairly... Can't even hit. There's a fairly good chance she's gonna end up dying from this. Let's have you attack this guy. Which is awesome. And then we need to get rid of this egg, or we can go around the egg, which might be easier. But I'd like to get rid of it just so I can see what I'm dealing with. Yep, there we go. And then I can have you hit this one. And we're good. So clearly we need to head over into this area, because there was a lapse over there that was attacking something. You're not going to have an easy time moving. You can't get past your friends. So let's just have you move up once. Awesome. So this person is in the worst situation. I guess that's because they have the least health. They only have 11, which is the second least. This person only has 10, and everyone else has 16 or 20. So we need to baby these guys, make sure they're extra safe. Was that... Okay, that was an alchemist. Can we throw... Yeah. You have a really short distance on these throws. We can shoot at least one of them. Oh, we can get for both. That doesn't make a difference too much which one we choose. So let's just get that guy. Our other archer had... I keep calling them archers. Our other hunter is way back here, so she won't be able to shoot. Let me bring this guy over. Oh, I can't. Everyone's stuck behind everybody else. It's a shame. And now you're drunk. You really shouldn't be drunk in just the middle of a fight. It's not a good thing. Yeah, you won't be able to do anything, so you can just end your turn. So I just noticed that it's the hunters that have, all the lowest healths. I wonder if that's a thing that's common to the hunters, or just these hunters that we have. You can kill this guy. That's good. There could be more in this area. I don't think so, though. I'm gonna just go on to this area to kill the lapse. That should be over here. Oh, there's another one over there. Okay. And another one over there. This one sees me, I believe. I think this one sees us too. So, the hunter can probably... No? Yes. The hunter can kill... Oh, maybe both of them, actually. No, can't reach that one. But you can reach this one. But you're not gonna kill it. It's only gonna do 8 to 11 damage. You might as well get some of it gone. It's gonna probably rush over here and do some damage. Wow, these guys have, like, no distance on... Oh, wait, do they? Oh, they have a little bit. Ugh, they can't... so close. It's not gonna work out, though. What about you? You have... No, you're not gonna be able to throw it. Are you? Maybe? If I could... Ooh. I think it's worth it. So let's try that. Oh, that actually worked out fine. He missed, but it just went further... it went closer, actually, to the lapse. So that ended up working out. Can I level you up right now? Oh, I can. Let's go with that. I didn't realize I could do that mid-battle. Okay. And I don't think... Oh, wait. I can reach you if you come over here. And then we could do that thing where we're gonna hit you twice. Second time for 50% of the damage. And that worked out wonderfully. I'm getting really lucky in this. Don't pollute. Oh boy. Oh, so their names that they have and the things that they say, when you start, you can pick if their names and, like, the sort of guilds that they come from are, funny or not. They call it thematic or non-thematic, and I made these guys have funny guilds and funny names, so some of the things that they call out are related to what they are. In one of the games that I played first, one of the families that it picked was like a font family, and they would talk about fonts all the time, and their names were like Helvetica and stuff. It was pretty cool. I could barely reach you. I could reach you better. But we don't really need that to kill you. I'm gonna hope this hits. I don't think it's going to. Oh, it did. But it didn't fully kill her. The lapses are a little bit more important than the seeds. Just because the lapses can take away health. Or not health, experience. Can I kill you? No. These are both archers. So I'm gonna have the first archer come up here and shoot the laps. The only problem is this guy has no health, so I have to make sure that this seed gets killed. Awesome. Good job. So I have to make sure that this seed gets killed over here. Please shoot. Please miss. Or not miss. Thank you. And then, oh, you leveled up. Awesome. So you're not gonna heal yourself or anything, but let's get that follow-up shot, which is really good, and then I don't think we'll. Yeah, we can't hit the laps from here, so I'm just gonna move everybody further up. Nobody else got hurt except for the hunters, which is, I guess, sort of good. I wish the hunters didn't get hurt because they're the best at killing, honestly. You're gonna attack. Oh, that's not cool. Yep, lost a little bit of experience. Oh, lost a level too. That's not cool. I want to kill this person from away because when they, I think I've already said that, but when they die, they explode and they stun people in a certain radius. So I'd prefer if the people who are killing her don't get stunned. So let's just attack from beyond like that. Oh, did you see the way that one went down? That's interesting. Okay. We got two people leveled up to level 3. I think it's only on the even levels, though, that they get skills. That's neat. Oh, that's what the. Right. The chalice is talking, and I put on subtitles since it's very quiet. I should probably increase the volume for that. Although I think it is increased all the way. Yeah, the volume's increased all the way, so I can't really do much about not being able to hear the massive chalice. Woo, we got a caberjack, my favorite. So these both have people in them, right? Yeah. So all we need to do is wait for research to happen. I'd like to get a crucible. Ooh, we had a baby. Oh, I wanted to look at the baby. The corruption spreading in the Pale Sea hasn't been taken well by the populace, and the simmering anger has been worked into a frenzy by the notorious chalice criticizer, Catherine Goodguy, resulting in riots. It being a region close to Gertie Geagle Flounder's heart, your hero has offered to ride back to the Pale Sea and attempt to quell the escalating fear and violence. So these are. I guess it's describing the situation. These can work out to, like, give them good traits, give them bad traits, a person could die, good stuff can happen occasionally, so. It's a little bit of a risk, a gamble to do this. So we can assassinate Catherine, we can send her to the Pale Sea to begin peaceful negotiations, or she can help but from the capital. See, peaceful negotiations sounds like the smartest thing to do, but I bet that that's actually gonna turn out badly. Well, let's do assassination just for funsies. Yep, so she's left, so we can no longer choose her for attacking. And let's see, we got two babies, did we? So we got Tau over here. Ooh, I can spin the cradle. How you doing? What traits do you have? You're brainy, strong-willed, and infertile. Well, 2 out of 3 is pretty good. And is that it? Oh yeah, one baby and then the event. Cool. Let's just continue on. Hope that health file comes around soon enough. You receive a package and a note from the riot leader, Catherine Goodguy. Ruler, if you wanted to kill me, why not do it yourself instead of sitting in the shadow of the chalice? Thanks to your laziness, the Pale Sea just had its first public execution in 200 years. Here's a memento. You dropped the package and can't even bear to look at it. Okay, so she's dead. So that wasn't a good decision, but she was a caberjack, so I don't really care. But yeah, that wasn't the best decision. I just thought that since it looked like it was gonna result badly, it was gonna be like a twist and it would actually end up well. Okay, so increased sight range. You're sickly. Oh, this is where it says what the traits do. Yeah, so you're Hawkeye, sickly, and a quick study. So again, 2 out of 3 good traits. Let's continue. The health file's right there. Awesome. So now we can finally apply the health file so people can heal in the middle of a battle. I think I want to do. Is it the Sage Knight skill? No, okay, the Sage Droid's Guild is for research. This is the one that trains people. I think that's just a good thing to have sooner rather than later. Although, I think I'm gonna upgrade the hunter armor first, just because... Oh no, it takes the same amount of time. Yeah, let's do that. Let's upgrade the armor first. What? Are you telling me that there's new stuff? Cool. Let me just get rid of all of that nonsense. Yeah. No, I wanted the whole hunter armor. Thank you. Oh wait, can I? Okay, I can quit. Yeah. That's probably just good, just so the hunters don't die in the meantime. After that is, and I think one of these guys, either the trick shot or the boom striker, I'm pretty sure the trick shot wears hunter armor and the boom striker wears alchemist armor. So this will help out the hunters and some hunter-like people for right now. A newborn baby boy and a lot of experience. This has ruptures, lapses, and seeds. And this has seeds and ruptures. So I'm gonna get ruptures no matter where I go. Wouldn't hurt to have an extra person in the kingdom. So everyone stayed alive, which is pretty nice. We're not missing anybody this time. I think they're good. Did it also automatically equip them with the health file? Looks like it. Because everyone has a little health file next to their names. Okay, let's try this out, see how it goes. So it's a funny thing, I time these episodes so that way they'll be around the same amount of time each and that they won't get too long or boring or be too short and just like a ripoff. And it so happens that this is when the episode is supposed to end. I don't know why it keeps happening that just as soon as we jump into these things it happens, but that's the situation. So I guess we'll resume this fight and see what happens in the next episode, and I will see you guys there. Bye!